Welcome students. In this lecture we are going to do a few problems in the chapter of fiber optics. This is the sixth chapter in your syllabus from the unit 3, module 3. So we have covered up all the theory of this chapter on fiber optics in the previous lectures. So in this last lecture here we are going to just do a few numerical problems which have come in the semester question papers. Okay, so I picked up some questions from there itself. So you can expect some similar type of problems. Remember, problems you can easily score marks because just you have to know a formula and then simple substitution you get a direct answer. Otherwise, if you have a question which is like explain how the optical fiber works or explain how the communication system using optical fiber works, you have to write quite at least one page of answer. Whereas in a problem, just one simple formula and substitution and answer with proper units will give you full 5 marks. Okay, so do not leave problems. They're very simple problems based on the formulas which we have already derived in the chapter. So let's start. The first problem is very simple. Direct substitution it is. For a step index fiber, the core refractive index is 1.5 and the cladding refractive index is 1.48. Calculate its critical angle, acceptance angle, numerical aperture, and fractional refractive index change. For all these 4 things, so we have to calculate 4 things here. One is the critical angle, second thing is the acceptance angle, third thing is the numerical aperture, and fourth thing is the fractional refractive index change. So 4 things you have to calculate, and all of this we have direct formulas to calculate this. Okay, so first of all, what is given to us is the refractive index of the core and refractive index of the cladding. Now, refractive index of the core, always you have to denote it as mu1. Always in this chapter, mu1 represents the refractive index of the core. So this is given to us as 1.5, and refractive index of cladding is always represented as mu2. It is given to us as 1.48. Always please note, mu1 core has a higher refractive index than the cladding. So mu1 is always greater than mu2. It has to be that way, okay? And we have followed this sign convention, followed this convention in this chapter that mu1 is core, mu2 is cladding, hence mu1 is greater than mu2. So always, in any problem, you'll always find this thing. mu1 will be greater than mu2. Now, first thing we need to calculate is the critical angle. Okay, critical angle. What's the formula for critical angle? It is denoted as IC. In the starting part when we talked about total internal reflection, we had obtained the formula for critical angle. Critical angle is sine inverse of mu2 by mu1. So this will be equal to sine inverse of 1.48 divided by 1.5. And this answer will come out to be, 80.6 degrees. So this is your value of critical angle. Next thing is the acceptance angle. Acceptance angle is denoted by the symbol I max. And what's the formula for I max? I max is sine inverse of root of mu1 square minus mu2 square, mu1 square minus mu2 square divided by mu0. Now what is mu1 then? mu1 is core, mu2 is cladding, and mu0 is the surrounding. Now in this problem here, the surrounding medium is not mentioned to us. So if any problem surrounding medium is not mentioned, we assume it to be air, and we take the value of mu0 as 1. Okay, so the surrounding medium, if it is not mentioned, assume that the surrounding medium is air and take the value of mu0 as 1. So this will become equal to sine inverse of root of 1.5 square minus 1.48 square divided by 1, and this answer will come out to be 14.1 degrees. So that's the value of your acceptance angle. So any ray which falls up to this angle will be accepted. If a ray is falling at an angle greater than 14.1 degrees, the ray will not be accepted by the fiber. Next thing, we have to calculate a numerical aperture, NA. This is simple. NA, numerical aperture, NA is equal to sine of IMAX. So simple formula. So we already calculated IMAX, so we have to just find sine of IMAX. So sine of 14.1, which is equal to 0.2436. So this is your value of numerical aperture. And last thing is to calculate the fractional refractive index change. Fractional refractive index change is denoted by the symbol delta. So delta, the formula is mu 1 minus mu 2 upon mu 1. So fractional refractive index change is defined as the change in refractive index per unit refractive index of core. So mu 1 minus mu 2 upon mu 1. So this will be 1.5 minus 1.48 divided by 1.5. And this answer will come out to be 0.013. So this is how we have calculated all the four parts. We have calculated critical angle, we have calculated acceptance angle, we have calculated numerical aperture and fractional refractive index change. So four things we have calculated. Next problem. A step index fiber in air has a numerical aperture of 0.18, core refractive index of 1.52 and core diameter of 60 micrometers. Determine the V number for the fiber when light of wavelength 1.15 micrometer is transmitted. Also estimate the number of modes the fiber will support. So now this is a problem where we have to find a V number. V number is also called as the normalized frequency. So what is the formula for the V number? V number is V is equal to 2 pi A upon lambda into numerical aperture. There's another formula also, 2 pi A upon lambda into root of mu 1 square minus mu 2 square. But for that, we require the values of core refractive index and cladding refractive index. Here, what is given to us is the numerical aperture is already given to us, NA is given. So we can use this formula for the calculation of V number. So now what is A there? A is the radius of the core. Okay? And lambda is the wavelength of the light which is passing through the fiber. So now here we can write this as 2 into 3.14 into A. Now radius of the core, diameter of the core is given to us as 60 micrometers. So the radius will be half of that, which will be 30 micrometers. So I can write it as 30 into 10 raised to power minus 6. Okay, micrometer. Micro stands for 10 raised to power minus 6. Divided by lambda is given to us as 1.15 micrometers. So 1.15 into 10 raised to power minus 6. And this full thing into numerical aperture 0.18. So this comes out to be 29.49. This is just a number, it doesn't have any units. So 29.49 is the V number. Now next thing, we also need to calculate or estimate the number of modes the fiber will support. And what type of fiber it is, it's given to us as a step index fiber. Now for a step index fiber, the number of modes it will support, we have a formula for it, approximate formula, estimated formula. It is V square by 2 for a step index. If it was a graded index fiber, this would have become V square by 4. So since it's given as a step index fiber, the formula for number of modes is estimated as V square by 2. So this will be 29.49 square divided by 2. So this will be equal to 434.8. Okay, so since this is a number of modes, modes cannot be fractions. It's either one mode or five modes or 10 modes. It cannot be 10.5. Okay, so we can round this up and say approximately equal to 435 modes. 435. So this is your estimated number of modes the fiber will support. The next problem, the last problem, an optical fiber is 3 meters long and has a core diameter of 30 micrometers. If a ray of light is incident on one end of the fiber at an angle of 30 degrees, how many reflections does it undergo before emerging from the other end? The core refractive index is 1.45. Now this is an interesting problem in which we are told to find out how many reflections are occurring inside the fiber. Light is entering from one end, coming out from the other end. In between, how many total internal reflections it is undergoing, that is what we need to find out. So let's draw the diagram of this so that we can analyze this problem better. So we have this optical fiber which is 3 meters long. This is the starting end of it. This is the core, cladding, sorry. This region is the cladding. This side also there will be cladding. Middle region here is the core. This is the core. And this, let us say, is the axis of the fiber. The axis. Now what is happening here? There is a ray of light which is incident at an angle of 30 degrees. So we will draw the incident ray. This angle here is 30 degrees. I is equal to 30. Then what happens to the ray? It will undergo a small refraction at this point. Slightly it will bend and hit the core cladding boundary at this point over here. Then from this point it will undergo a total internal reflection and it will come this way. Again, at this point it will hit the core cladding boundary and it will again undergo a total internal reflection and then it will go this way and then that will keep on continuing till it comes out from the other end. Now this other end is how much far away? For this given problem, the fiber is 3 meters long. Okay. Now, what we need to find out is how many reflections are occurring. Now in this figure here, I have shown you only one and two reflections, two total internal reflections. There will be many more occurring before the fiber comes out from the other end. So the question is, how many such total internal reflections are occurring within the fiber? So to find out that, what we'll have to do is, we'll have to slightly analyze this figure. And if you carefully observe here, for this reflection, for this first reflection which is occurring, we can associate a distance from this point to this point. So this much distance, I can say that it is associated with the first reflection. I'll call this distance as L. Similarly, distance from here to here, I can associate it with the second reflection, this second reflection. This also will be equal to L because the symmetry of the figure, if you, though it doesn't seem to be exactly equal, but if you, because the reflections are occurring at symmetric angles, this distance L and this distance L will be same. So like that, we can associate distances L with every reflection. So for one reflection, the distance travelled along the fiber is L. For the second reflection, distance travelled is another L. So like that, how many such L's will be there? That will give us the number of reflections. So if we find out the value of L, we know the total length of the fiber is 3 meters. So the number of total number of reflections will then be, if distance travelled for one reflection is L and the total length of the fiber is 3 meters, so total length, which is 3, divided by the length for one reflection. Total length is 3 divided by the length of one reflection is L. So this will give you the total number of reflections. So therefore, all I need to find out is this value of L. So now to find out that value, you will have to do some simple trigonometric ratios there. So how can we do it? If I label this point as A, I'll draw a normal from this point, and this point over here I'll label it as B, this point I'll label it as C, and this point over here I'll label it as D. So we have two triangles, two right angle triangles, ABC and triangle CBD, two right angle triangles. Now these two triangles, ABC and triangle CBD, they will be congruent. Why? Because you can prove that they are congruent, these angles are same, this is a reflection occurring there, same, two angles are 90 degrees and they have a common side. So therefore their two triangles are congruent. Therefore I can write that the distance AB is equal to the distance BD. And hence from this I can write that the distance L, which is equal to AB plus BD, I can write it as equal to just 2 times AB. Right? Because AB and BD are equal. So AB plus AB it will become, so it will become 2 times AB. So the distance L is equal to 2 times AB. So all that we need to do is therefore find the value of AB. So once you find the value of AB, we can calculate L. And once you calculate L, we can use this formula and calculate the total number of reflections occurring in the fiber. So let's see how we can find the value of AB. So to find the value of AB, you will have to find this angle first. Okay, this angle CAB, the angle CAB, you will need to find out first. So for that, we'll have to use the Snell's law. What is the Snell's law? Snell's law says that sine I upon sine R, this angle here is R, it's angle of refraction. If this angle here is angle of incidence, this angle here is angle of refraction. So we can apply Snell's law for that. Sine I upon sine R is equal to refractive index of the second medium upon refractive index of the first medium. Light is going from this medium here outside of the fiber to the core of the fiber. So the second medium is the core here and the first medium is the surrounding. So it's going from surrounding to core. So the second medium is mu 1. Fiber core has a refractive index mu 1. And outside surrounding, we'll assume that the refractive index is mu 0. Which in case it is air, mu 0 value will be 1. Okay? So sine I upon sine R is mu 1 upon mu 0. This is the Snell's law. So we can put the values over here. Sine I is sine of 30 divided by sine R. We have to find the value of R. Mu 1 value is given to us, that's the refractive index of the core, 1.45, and mu 0 value is 1 because we are assuming that the surrounding is air. So from this, what will be sine R? Sine R will be equal to sine 30 divided by 1.45. You can calculate this and see it will come out to be 0.3448. So that's sine R. So what is R then? R will be sine inverse of that. Sine inverse of 0.3448. This will come out to be, if you can on a calculator you can do it, 20.17 degrees. So we have got the value of R. Now once we get the value of R here, we are going to apply, consider the triangle ABC. So in triangle ABC, what will be 10 of R? In triangle ABC, 10 R will be opposite side upon adjacent side. So it will be CB upon AB. 10 R will be CB upon AB. So we are interested in the value of AB. Remember, we need to find the value of AB here. To find the value of L, we need to find the value of AB. So what will be AB then? AB will be CB upon 10 R. So how much is the value of CB now? Look in the figure there. What is CB? CB is the distance from here to here. Okay. Now the diameter of the core is given to us as 30 micrometers. So this entire distance from here to here is 30 micrometers. So CB is half that. It's a radius. CB is a radius of the core. So it will be 15 micrometers. So the value of CB is 15 micrometers. So this will be 15 into 10 raised to power minus 6, micro is 10 raised to power minus 6, 10 of R, R value we know, it is 20.17. This will come out to be 4.083 into 10 raised to power minus 5 meters. So this is the value of AB we got. Now next thing, we need to find the value of L. What is L? L is here, it is 2 times AB. So L, which is equal to 2 times AB, will be equal to 2 into 4.083 into 10 raised to power minus 5, and this value will be coming out to be 8.167 into 10 raised to power minus 5 meters. So now we got the value of L. Now to find the total number of reflection, we use this formula. It is the total length of the fiber, which is 3 meters, divided by the distance associated with one reflection, which is L. Okay, so 3 divided by L will give us the total number of reflections. So that's the final thing. Total number of reflections is equal to 3 divided by L, which is equal to 3 divided by 8.167 into 10 raised to power minus 5, and this answer will be 36,733. So this is your final answer. So you can imagine, so by the time the fiber comes out, light comes out of the other end of the fiber, it will undergo 36,733 total internal reflections, and this is just a 3 meter long fiber. Normally for telecommunication purpose, in between exchanges, one exchange and the other, the optical fiber has a length of around might be 5 kilometers, 10 kilometers. So you can imagine how many number of reflections, the total number of reflections actually occur in the optical fiber. And if at every reflection energy was lost, then by the time the light reached the other end of the fiber, the intensity of the light would have been very, very small. But what happens in total internal reflection? We know in a total internal reflection, when light undergoes TIR, at this point here, there is absolutely no energy lost. In total internal reflection, there is no energy lost. So therefore, even if 36 tells this many huge number of reflections, total internal reflections are occurring within the fiber, whatever intensity light was entering the fiber, almost the same intensity comes out from the other end of the fiber. So without much loss of energy. So that is why we use the phenomena of total internal reflection for the working of the optical fiber. So with this, we end this chapter and the problems in this chapter.